All right. Biochar as a soil fertilizer is not a novel concept. In fact, it's been around about 25 times longer than Betty White has blessed this good earth. Biochar in temperate agriculture, however, came around this decade and provides a new and kind of hot way of looking at soil sciences. So, simply put, biochar is charcoal that is added to soil with the intent of improving it and increasing crop yields. This biochar is comprised of highly stable carbon forms that are resistant to degradation for even thousands of years. And this gives us the unique opportunity of being able to take plants, which are full of atmospheric carbon, convert them into biochar, and add this to the soil, thus trapping carbon in the Alcatraz of the carbon cycle. Not only does biochar affect greenhouse gas cycling this way, but it also changes microbial communities within the soil, such that they produce less carbon dioxide and nitrous oxide, which is an especially bad greenhouse gas. Now, the benefits of biochar to crop growth have been well documented in the tropics for even thousands of years. However, the same has not been seen when copying and pasting these amendments into temperate agriculture. And as a soil scientist, this isn't terribly shocking, because not all soils are created equal. Temperate soils are very young, which means they have higher pHs, high soil organic matter, and high activity clays, which all just means it's great for agriculture. Or as I like to say, we have strong independent soils who don't need no biochar to produce corn. However, the exception to this is our sandy soils, which I study. So the objectives of my research are to find opportunities where biochar can work in temperate agriculture and be beneficial. To do this, I'm comparing three types of treatment in Bayfield, Ontario. The first is manure and fertilizer, which is a traditional nutrient mix. The second is manure and biochar. And finally, manure, biochar, and fertilizer. Once these have been added, I look at the effects of this on microbial communities in the soil, crop growth, and general soil health. If the hypothesized outcomes of my research are realized, this could provide governments with an opportunity to meet carbon sequestration goals. As well, it can give farmers the opportunity to be less reliant on nitrogen fertilizers, saving them money, protecting the atmosphere from nitrous oxide again, as well as protecting fresh water in Ontario, which is dramatically impacted by excessive nitrogen. So, in the midst of climate change, environmental issues, and food security issues, biochar is showing that it too can be maybe quite as legendary as Betty White herself. Thank you.